Fatima's next job could be in cyber. She just doesn't know it yet. Fatima's practiced ballet since 5, gone to countless concerts, lessons, and yet our government, who created this advert, deems her job expendable, useless. She should go into cyber. Why? At primary school, all subjects are merited equally, lauded for both confused science experiments and painful music recitals. But something happens when important decisions begin. At secondary school, GCSE, the creativity of kids is suddenly reprimanded. Parents beg children who have previously devoted their lives to stage plays and monologues to avoid drama GCSE like the plague, breathing a sigh of relief when their perfect son decides triple science might be a nice idea. People see the arts as unimportant, unemployable, and unworthy of emphasis in education. I pose the question, should arts education, i.e. music, arts, drama, dance, be neglected in favour of STEM? To which, spoiler, my answer is no. So what's actually happening? Well, STEM predominates UK education. Maths and science GCSEs are compulsory, and the government increased funding, training, and STEM career planning. Meanwhile, the arts are deemed unworthy, excluded from the English baccalaureate, the official measure of a school's GCSE attainment. Art education lacks money and respect. In 2021 alone, the government approved plans to halve the university arts and design budget and completely cut funding for several BTEC courses like performing arts. This impacts arts uptake. From 2010 to 18, GCSE arts entries fell 35%. Often people justify this, claiming STEM is more useful or employable than the arts, particularly given the intensifying presence of technology in our lives. Undoubtedly, STEM expertise is essential, but the arts too. All vast technological industries require art-specific skills, designing, ad-making, and creativity itself drives innovation. Take Steve Jobs, who credited the impressive typography of Apple to a university calligraphy course. Also, believe it or not, there is more to life than Alexa and automated vacuum cleaners. Arts careers have immense scope, from writing era-defining music to designing your clothes. These undervalued careers form the cultural fibre of our world and are simply indispensable. There is too a personal and social imperative for the arts. Through creative mediums, students can express themselves, fostering self-confidence and authenticity. Vital in a world of restrictive technology, the prominence of art therapy is no coincidence. Furthermore, the expressiveness of the arts commands empathy, making it a crucial motivator for social change. For instance, Sam Cooke's massively influential civil rights movement music. Many people argue instead that STEM is somehow more academic than the arts, so the arts hold no curricular purpose. This bias is propositioned by media like Fatima, our hapless ballerina, and easily observed in real life. My own interest in science is seen as intelligent and studious. My interest in music, passionate, a hobby. I think that instead of encouraging kids to strive to this supposed academia of STEM, our biases towards the subject are just creating a demoralizing, polarizing hierarchy of intelligence, quick to sort people into smart and STEM, dumb and arty. This disregards the abilities of people who excel in the arts. After all, why is aptitude in, say, minimalism, any less valid than aptitude in organic chemistry? I often hear that the joy art brings somehow dismisses its academic rigour, but surely the point of work is not misery. Indeed, liking a subject will often mean you work more. Look no further than MP Vicky Foxcroft, who credits her educational success to a performing arts BTEC. The very same qualification our government has withdrawn funding from. Neglecting the arts forces people into subjects that may lower their academic attainment and disengage them from education. And what even is academia anyways, but engagement with education? Moreover, without curricular arts, it'll become sidelined into expensive extracurriculars that many simply won't be able to afford. Art, as we've said, can influence the world with its narrative. and the influential narrative being spun is one of immense privilege that lacks representation. In turn, even fewer people see art as a viable option. Evidently, this elitism is already pervasive. So overall, no, arts education should not be neglected. STEM and arts really are just two facets of innovation, both with myriads of benefits. Perhaps combining the two into an interdisciplinary curriculum would be the best of both worlds, ensuring that the arts are respected for their capabilities of immense global improvement. Because maybe it's not Fatima who should rethink, reskill, reboot her whole life, but us, who must urgently reevaluate our attitudes towards the arts. Thank you.